Well, hello.
I decided to record this video in English so more of you would understand what I'm talking about. And today I wanted to show you some of the false coins, euro coins, 2 euro coins from Italy. I live here, so I'm aware that in tourist periods of the year, there is a bigger quantity of false coins that you can find in your pocket. So I don't know, like 5-10 days ago, I found another one. The one in here, I found 2018, circa. This one, I found like 5 days ago, and these two are the original ones. Now, the worrying thing that I would want you to know about is that the false coins nowadays became much harder to recognize, and while the stamp quality, the quality, general quality of the coin remained the same or even worse, but the thing is, they managed to reproduce the magnetic properties of the original coins, and that's the worrying thing. Now, the government or the articles that you find on the internet that talk about false coins often talk about trying them with magnets, yes, but in this case it's useless, because you trying it with a magnet, you see the result of the original coin. So now, here I have two magnets and two markers. Now I will mark these coins for you to see which one is which one. These two will remain normal. Now, the old false, I will write an F, red F. And the new false, I'll write an F and blue F. Okay. Yo. Now, how you can recognize the false coins from the real coins nowadays? The thing is, original ones are magnetic in the middle of the coin, not much, but the magnet attracts the coin, even the smaller one. Okay, the border is not magnetic at all. And now with the bigger one, you can clearly see that the coin attacks in the middle. Okay, and the original one from 2002 has the same behavior. Okay, now the old falses were like this. They attach in the border, okay, and that was the easy way to find out. Now the central part is not magnetic at all, probably made from bronze or Yeah, something like that. And the worrying part arrives now. You see, the problem is that nowadays the forces attack in the middle and do not attack on the border. This is worrying, of course. You can clearly see that this is they managed to reproduce the properties. Okay. For you to view a better quality, I'll clean the coins and or even not, and I'll take some pictures, some greater quality pictures, and put them into the video on the end right now. So be aware of what you have in your pocket. A surprise cut, because I simply forgot about the most satisfying test of all, the one that you can actually hear. So these coins make a different sound too. If you throw a coin, original coin, on the ground, it makes sounds, metallic sound. The you can hear the vibrations of the coin. It's not very much, but you can hear the quality of the coin. Now this. This sounds different, and this one sounds like lead. Yep. And the original. These are the same, literally the same. Now this has a good sound, and almost too good, much metallic. Now this one seems lead. It's not even bouncing. This should be made from a very soft metal. Well, here you can clearly see this one bouncing. The border is made from a very hard metal, I think, in this one. You can see the original bounces, but doesn't bounce like a rabbit, like this one, for example. This one bounces like a rabbit. And this one is on the contrary level. Okay. So now we're finished. Salute.